Brother,
Hey, sorry, man.
you're good,
I was
dude.
gone. I was gone for a week in California, and now I'm so backlogged on all these games.
Oh, that's funny, man. Where were you in California?
Anaheim, Cerritos area, like near Long
Nice.
Beach Airport.
Yeah, you're good. You know I'm from there.
No, really? Are you there now?
No, born and raised though. I'm out here in PA now, but
What area?
I was from originally Whittier, which is,
Okay.
yeah, just a little bit from Cerritos. Like I went to school in La Mirada, 15 minutes
Oh,
from,
hey, yeah.
yeah, so good
Cal
stuff.
Poly.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Did
All
they advance the
right,
week yet?
they
Last I checked,
did.
we were still in preseason.
No, they advanced, so you probably have to go on and do a bunch of the press stuff.
Nah, I'm good, dude. I'll
All right, when you're on, let me
edit.
know from the franchise because we have to push play season game at the same time.
I normally have one person just start it and then have them invite me. But the weird thing is that I have to be out in like the main menu of the game to accept the invite. Otherwise, it
Oh.
won't work. It makes no sense.
We'll see what happens. Did that work? Let's see. Invite will be sent.
I'm waiting on that invite still. But yeah, that's normally how I've had to do it in Madden, in both Xbox and
Okay.
the league. But yeah, man, California's nuts, man. It's so nice out there. It was like 70 degrees ish
yeah.
the whole time when we were there. Nice and breezy, but like all these like small petty crime going on everywhere, man.
Yep. Story of my life. That's crazy. You were right there. Were you like, did you go to Disneyland and stuff? You said Anaheim.
No, not this time. We went the first time we went. It was like a year or
Okay.
so. Like we went to Disneyland then, but this time around, I was only there for 3 days.
All right.
I barely still see invite. I'm loading in.
Cool. Hopefully the internet's gonna be all right. They want me streaming this thing, so.
Are you streaming it right now?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Got a whole one viewer, guys. It's probably
Hey, there
Paul.
you go. There you go.
To the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments
Alrighty,
ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with the Indianapolis Colts.
nice.
Ooh, 2 points.
Got this rookie QB. We'll see how it goes.
Oh my God. Fucking Trevor.
A running play there, gonna get 11 as they get
Already?
another first down on that
Second.
last run. He's now hit the 6,000 yard mark for rushing yards in his career.
And moves him squarely into the top 100 rushers of all time. In fact, he can boast that he's rushed for over 1,000 yards more than Gale Sayers did in his career. And Gale Sayers was a Hall of Famer in a short career.
And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Uh-oh.
First down, this is
Ooh.
Everett.
There you
And he
go.
sneaks his way forward only for a couple here.
Go slow
Second
him
down.
down. Bro, it's Christian
Well, any lane that might have been
Yeah, I
open there
know.
was closed pretty quickly, and that was
He sees a
because the
hole and he's
defensive
gone.
front they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And going deep for Hill.
Wow.
He's caught inside
he's so
the 15.
Fast.
Tyreek Hill, 48 yards. And the Colts are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Yeah, I feel bad. Your team kind of got decimated, bro. Right? I think one of the guys took Najee.
TJ Watt was gone. All the.
Oh no, Julian Blackman.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the.
I just had a breakout with him. That sucks.
Not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's Max again on second down. And he'll get this one up to the 26. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2. Here's Hurts to throw. Escaping the pressure right.
Oh my gosh.
Wow, what a grab.
That's funny.
At the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. This seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
No way! Look at that. That was good.
Yeah, Juju's not on the team anymore.
Juju Smith-Schuster, 61 yards. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point attempt to come here.
Oh, God.
It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns. They're tied 7-7.
Shut up! This hurts my soul as a Ravens fan.
Oh, are you a Ravens fan?
Yes.
That's this, funny.
This sucks.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they get another shot here with a 1st and 10. Eluding the pressure right.
Uh-oh.
And going deep for Hill. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
He's got one touchdown pass already in this quarter. Obviously looking for number 2. And definitely not playing the check down game.
Here's 2nd and 10. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
Ah, fudge.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A nice completion there for the 1st down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week 1. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent.
Oh, come on, Hayward. You're killing me.
The best part about his game has his team run the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles.
Oy.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress. And I think that forced the incompletion downfield.
Whoa. Straight up three.
Your center and guard did not even touch him.
I know.
Busting through to get him for a loss of six.
And McCaffrey just stood there.
Yeah, it sure did.
Come on, bro, just block.
It's like, nah, man, I'm a dancer.
Or get out. If you get out of the way, then get out of the way.
Hey, guys, that's an annoying horn.
This is intercepted. Picked by Trayvon Mullen. And the Steelers are going to have the short field.
Good job, dude.
Right at the 50. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three.
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go. 58, boys. 58.
58. 60 Bison. 60 Bison. Hurts sets up to throw it. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. And he's taken down inside the 30. Under a minute to go. Clock running in a back and forth first quarter play. They'll run on first down on the mat. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Here's Mack to get it again on second down. That heavy brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Seven, our score after one.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Double tight. Everyone's got four down. 60 Eagles.
Throwing his Hurts. The left side caught by the tight end Freiermuth. 7 yards, the pick up there. On second down now, it's Mack, and this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. From the gun, it's Hurts. Quickly here, that's complete. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate.
Oh, what are you doing? Stupid.
In the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone,
hate you,
and find
man.
The first down. And that's what he just did.
It'll be a pickup of four, and it brings up second and goal.
What call is this?
Nice.
Off the edge, and that's complete. Guys, man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Tim Patrick there to make the grab, and the Steelers have taken the lead. Extra point by Bass. Up and good.
Oh, my God, shut up.
Actually, no. Oh, no.
What? You're nuts.
Bro, that's killing me. That was terrible. What is that? Oh, my goodness. I don't want to just get a safety over there. That's crazy that just happened.
That last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
Oh, shoot. I forgot I got.
Back to throw now. It his own end zone. Quick slant to Hill. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. Another completion there. And we think back to the draft in the spring. This franchise essentially handing him the keys to the operation. A top five pick. Charles, how ready do you think he is?
I think he's ready for the NFL in terms of size, speed, the makeup of him, the character of him. The key's going to be, will this team accept everything he brings to the game and adapt to it, not just necessarily plug him into something that he doesn't do well.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Mike, 45. Watch the out. Watch the out. 45 for Mike. Let's go, D. Big series right here. We got to step it up.
Man, cycle.
They'll look to throw here. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down.
What is that noise?
And a quick throw here. That's
no!
And the out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big connection on that one. 39 yards.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is
oh, did
so
it hurt me?
To get down
did
in
it?
The open field. They just want to get him to
play. Is that what it said?
Yeah, it was like, what really hurt on that play was that missed tackle.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. Yeah, baby. Yeah. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter. 14-7. Oh, yeah. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. And he gets it down to the 32.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Looking to throw. And he'll just get rid of it.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10.
What are you doing? Oh my god. That middle linebacker just watched it sail over his face. What are you doing, bro?
Back to the ground attack here. It's McCaffrey. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. From the shotgun to McCaffrey.
Oh, he missed it. There we go.
That's touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. 9-yard touchdown run. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half.
You had it at like the 1. Yeah, that was a crazy drive, bro. 98 yards.
Some yardage here, maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. Hurts throw here pulled in by Hilton. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. They'll run on first down. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss.
Inbounds!
Firemuth right side. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
It's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
I was gonna whack you, bro. I was gonna.
Nope, no, you ain't. My whole season.
His teammates are certainly going to appreciate that effort, even his coaches don't, because they would want him to slide to protect himself. But he chose team game.
Bro, you're getting too many yards and going out of bounds.
Just a yard or two shy of the 30. And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Oh my gosh.
He reached the 5-yard line before going out of bounds.
We have a nice
decision for him to know that when he gets
I hate playing with him.
He's got a reliable tight end he can go to, so he's able to look his way, find his big target, and set up first.
No! I need to get there, baby. Come on.
Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target.
I got enough time. I got enough time.
And that one's incomplete.
6 seconds is a lot of time.
Once again, the five as they get ready for second and goal.
No way, bro. I was freaking there, bro. That's ridiculous.
Oh,
that is so dumb, bro. Not gonna make that mistake again.
I was gonna say that.
That's crazy. What should I do here?
His defensive playbook is weird. It's a 3-4, but some of the formations.
The Colts come to the line, ready to start their next drive. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission.
Oh.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
Oh.
Incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. This taken in at the goal line. And he returns this to the 22. Second and nine. They go right back to back. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll try and run for this with Matt. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Here's Hill.
Wow.
A good return there. 17 yards. And the Colts will go on offense here. First and 10.
Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in here?
Off the block.
You can sense him saying, okay, the first half was theirs, but now let's get the momentum back on our side. We forced a punt. Now let's go downfield and score. If we do that, we'll be set up well for this second half.
Come on, Hayward. Oh my gosh. Get there, you stupid person, bro. How you beat everybody, but you... What a game, bro.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
All right. Four wide receivers. Interesting.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Here's Matt to
go. Oh.
And he'll get about four across the 30 to the 32.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down. Way forward for about four. Second and six.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Here's Mack to get it again on second down. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down at the Colts 44. This is third and one. Very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though.
Oh, you stupid man.
Well timed there, and now fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want. Anytime they want to throw the football, there was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one.
I don't even trust that guy anymore.
He's coming.
No! Come on, man. You had one job. Oh, Matt got hurt, huh?
I actually wasn't sure that he got it, but he ended up getting it by about a full yard.
He certainly did, but it took a little effort, didn't it? Took some nice push, a little crease inside, and some determined running to make sure that he got the first down.
Status for net, but he can only manage a yard or so before he's brought down. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They'll drop to throw. Looking deep for Hilton.
Wow.
This will be intercepted.
Get up and go. Hey, Blackman! That's the guy I'm on breakout with.
So the deep ball giveth, and now the deep ball taketh away.
Man, you're getting deep on me here. I like that. Going to the next level of what you're thinking. And when you think about all the success he's had throwing the football so far, sometimes when you're doing that, you think you're invincible out there. But he was given a cold dose of reality on that throw. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. They're going deep for Hill. And that is incomplete.
What?
What?
How did that happen?
I don't know, man.
Sure that he put it where either his
Interesting.
Guy was going to catch it or no one was.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again, eluding the pressure.
Oh,
deep for Hill, and that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Whenever you see a quarterback break contain, just think to yourself, the receivers on that side of the field, their number one job, make sure they get in his sight line.
How are there four people watching right now? We don't even have four people on
there. What the heck? They weren't able to connect.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
All right, well, let me try something different here. Nice. This is actually going to screw me off. What do I want to do here?
Hey, Pittsburgh, stop that noise, dude.
I know, for real.
What the frick, man? This is going on forever.
It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here.
I'm the home team.
It's still going.
Yeah.
What the heck? That's really bad.
How is this not illegal?
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the
Hollywood Brown conversion.
Yes, sir.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Another run with McCaffrey on
Sunday. And
he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive game. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Colts on third down.
There's that noise again.
This is third and 4. He'll set up a throw. Flushed out right. On the run. He'll let this go deep right side.
Man, he just busts all the zones.
Nice job.
Let's go party.
Have so much fun.
I love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. There's still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one possession game. Eight. They'll be looking for the touchdown and 2-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. They don't necessarily need a touchdown. They'll run on first down. Mack. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. They'll look to throw.
Oh, fudge. Damn. I didn't think the corner was in the zone. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line.
Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception. And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Ready. Oh.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense. Just take care of it, and they got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And this play will be blown.
Oh, Lindsay.
Back at the 38.
That's not good.
This was boxing. You think maybe they would have thought about stopping this one, because this defense has been bruised, it's been battered. But this is why they keep the fight going, right? They just got done with a really nice play, showing that they still got a little bit left, don't they?
Haven't had many plays that they can clip, put in the film room, and smile about, but hey, there's one.
Clip and save.
Second and 12. Flush to his right.
Ah, dang, man. Same spot over and over again. They can't get over it. I know. Oh, broken ribs. He's a big part of my O-line.
Openers are able to extend their lead. Turning into a really good performance.
That's not
on the
good.
Road. Week one, you're just hoping for that first win. It's tough to do it away from home, though, but they're looking strong.
It certainly is. Any road win in the NFL is a great road win. I mean, it just does not matter.
Because you're Baker for Hill and McCaffrey. In this that's what Ben says. Nice. Yeah, you can have him.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or maybe just throw that out the
way? I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, it didn't affect me. It's just going to be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. From the 29, Hurts. Ebron with it over the middle. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They'll run it out of the gun with Mack. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Now the pass finding its way into the hands of Eric Ebron. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right? Safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but more mainly they want him out there to block. Is an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Give me that one.
So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And it's incomplete.
You there still?
Now the focus is really clear.
Yeah.
They need to get that first down and either get out of bounds or maybe use one of those timeouts.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
God damn it.
And that should do it.
God damn it, Bobby.
By Kenny Moore. with the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along. If you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. And quick throw here, that's complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Incomplete. Stops with 10 seconds left.
This is really impressive because when the offenses are running RPOs, things move very quickly. Fake, ball's out of his hands, and they're trying to hit him in the gaps downfield. And instead, the defender reacts so well that he makes a play on it, and the ball falls incomplete.
Ooh, straight up, bro. Nice game, bro.
Yeah, man, I gotta figure out how to stop Tyreek, man.
And I mean,
he busts all my coverage. Like, I
did it. Time out.
Nah, it's still about it.
Yeah, he's kind of broken. His speed's is 99. He starts, you know, that's how it is.
So. Well, the free safety doesn't even go with him in the zone coverage. Really
right, yeah.
Corner's not fast enough to bring back here.
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just gone.
It's part of, I mean, part of it is his X factor, I think, too.
So for Indianapolis, but you get a win, you get it on the road. It's for much more than that.
GG, man.
All right, yeah, man. Good game. I'll talk to you soon.
All right, see you later.
Meanwhile, for